Palais Garnier, home of the Paris Opera for 114 years. Designed by Charles Garnier in 1860, it finally opened its doors to the public on January the 5th, 1875. Here, seven stories below ground level, lies a dark, forbidden world of cavernous chambers, forgotten cellars, and a labyrinth of menacing corridors and hidden passageways. In the midst of which is a mysterious underground lake. Above ground, the opera house was to achieve fame for its numerous opening night scandals, as much as for its spectacular productions. But here, below ground, it was to achieve fame as an opera house for a very different reason. In 1911, the writer Gaston Leroux used it as a setting for his novel, La Fantôme de l'Opéra. The book aroused little public interest until later, when its serialization in an American newspaper attracted the attention of a researcher working at Universal Studios. Leroux's story of a mad, disfigured composer haunting the darkest regions of this awesome building was about to achieve worldwide fame as it was turned into one of the masterpieces of silent film. The popular press called it Universal's million-dollar super jewel production. No expense had been spared. The lavish interior of the Paris Opera House was painstakingly reconstructed. Come with me now, back to the end of the last century, to the Paris Opera House. Le Palais Garnier, with its opulent heaven of marble and gilt glittering above, while below lies the tormented hell of darkness. Here lie the chambers of death, where shadows linger and time stands still. Nothing moves, save rats and spiders who have made these damp, cold stones their home. Nothing moves. And yet, the ghosts of madness stalk this lonely realm to chill the blood and stir one's darkest fears with strange imaginings, to glimpse the silent shadow of he who rules this grim terrain. His ghastly face forever hidden from the light. For he is master here. The Fantôme. The Fantôme of the Opera.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.